How do you do? I'm Graham Murphy, a product manager here at Tech Rentals. Today we're just going to look at the Stalker Pro II Kit. It is a radar gun. Now we'll just go through the parts in the kit so you can see what you get and you can see the applications it can be applied to. So we've got, this is the radar gun. The handle is a, we've got a battery built in. We've got the stand for it if necessary. There's the clips for the stand. Here's a display, a large display to indicate the speed that it's read. We've got a power supply for the display which subsequently powers this unit. Another power supply that we can use to charge up this. You need this adapter in order to charge it up. And then here's the cable between the instrument and the display. Now, to configure it, I need to put power onto the system. So I'm just going to attach the battery. So we'll just slot the battery in here, rotate that left, bring that down, and we switch it on. Now we've got the instrument turned on. Now we're never that certain how it's going to be configured. I've always got to check its configuration. At the moment, if I turn this transmit off, I can see the fact that it's been set up for car. Now, to program it and check the setup, we hit the menu key, which drops us into a menu. Now these two keys are up and down. So I'm going to go, I can set the range, we can change the range if necessary. At the moment I'll just leave it on 4. Now I hit select, jump from the range, direction whether it's inbound or outbound. Well, I might in this case set it as outbound. Menu again, the light's on, and just a battery option there. Now when we're in this menu, there is an extra menu a little deeper than this. We hold this keyed in for seconds. Now we've dropped to this next menu. Now this is the low velocity, the high velocity you'll read. The units, which is kilometers per hour, you can put it in meters per second, whether we want tenths displayed or not. Now in this case the target is set to car. Now we've got other targets, we've got tennis, we've got ball, or carnival. In this case we're going to leave it at car. Now I hit the menu key to jump again. It'll hold the display for 3 seconds. Right, there are three types of triggers. There's continuous trigger, start, stop, trigger operation, or LOC, when the transmitter is turned on using the transmit key on the rear panel. In other words, in this case, because we're going to be running it with the larger display, I'm going to actually set this to LOC. Okay, so we don't need to push the trigger, but if you were going to push the trigger, you would simply use start, stop with trigger operation. Now I hit the next key, auxiliary, we're not using that. Now the angle is an interesting one. That's the angle from which you're actually making the measurement. So if you're 15 degrees off from the actual angle that the cars are driving past, for example, you would need to set this to about 215 degrees or 10 degrees or whatever. In this case, we're actually directly in line with any measurements make, so I'm going to leave it at 0, but you need to double check this. Menu and board rate, we're not interested in the rest. Now, when you've completed that, you simply push the trigger to go back. At the moment, we can just get a straight measurement there and it is transmitting the measurement because we've got the XMIT key pressed. Now we can turn XMIT off and nothing's going to work. So we need to have XMIT turned on and we'll get a measurement. Right, we're going to configure this thing to operate with the display. And by the way, we actually don't need the handle on this to operate it because it gets power from the screen. So I'll just remove the battery. So I've just taken the battery off. Okay, now cable supplied, I'm just going to plug the instrument in here and plug the display in here. So now I can interconnect the two and I'm going to put AC power onto the display. Now the instrument hasn't started yet, I just need to turn the power on and it's already working. Okay, for mounting purposes there's hooks at the top here and little legs that we can flip out and they stabilize it. Okay, this is one instrument where you actually should really have a look at the manual depending upon how you're configuring it. In the manual here on page 19 it gives you the configuration for baseball, cricket, and carnival use, vehicles, racing, and tennis, etc. Now you saw it the display move there, that's because the energy, the microwaves this thing's putting out, will, if I wave my arm around, it'll pick it up because we're in a confined space. Normally you'd be outside where that won't be an issue, but you have to think about it. I.e. if you've got a large wall in front of you, you may get reflections from the wall, etc. Now, the other thing is the fact you've got to consider is the angle at which you're making the measurement. There's a discussion here on page 32. The angle with which you make the measurement, the gun will automatically compensate accordingly if you set the angle in during that inner configuration menu. It's a nice little instrument. It's pretty easy to set up. Gets a great result. And if I throw the ball, there we go.